What's up everyone, my name is Saahil and welcome back to my channel. And today I want to talk to you about skincare. A little off late, you know, all of you have been asking me a ton of questions about skincare and I thought these are very pertinent questions and I must answer them since you guys are asking me. And today I thought I would start a new series called Skincare Basics 101 where I can guide every one of you towards better skin. And what better way to start it than determining your skin type. First things first, what is skin type? Now essentially, skin type is the amount of sebum production in your skin. Sebum is this yellowish oily substance which exists in the sebaceous glands of your skin, which essentially prevent the moisture from evaporating or like leaving your skin and helping your skin just be moisturized and plump. So that's basically what skin type is. The level of oiliness on your skin is essentially your skin type. It's absolutely necessary to know your skin type because then you can go and buy the skincare products which suit your skin. So if your skin type is a certain way and you go buy the products of a certain kind and they do not match, the discrepancy between these two will really spoil your skin. Just like life, there are various reasons like your genes, your hormones, your age, the environment, the diet, the stress levels. A bunch of things contribute to the skin type you have, and that's why your skin type, just like life, keeps changing. So I actually, through my teenage days, had like really, really oily skin. But off late, now that I'm in my late 20s, I have combination skin, which I'll get into what is it. But what I'm trying to say is very important to know that your skin type can also change. That's why you should keep monitoring what your skin type is every couple of months so that you always know the right skincare products to choose from. So knowing your skin type and using the right skincare products will be able to harmonize the skin irregularities which you may have, like acne, excessive dryness, or you know, fine lines. So all these things can be harmonized and be prevented if you know the right skincare products and your skin type. There are essentially four. There's oily, there's dry, there's combined, and there's normal. There are two more, but they're more like skin conditions than actually skin type, which is mature skin and sensitive skin. So let's start with oily skin. When your skin is overproducing sebum, overproducing oil, you can call yourself a person with an oily skin. Essentially, the T-zone area and also the cheeks are very, very greasy, and this is where most of the oil will be found. So how can you determine an oily skin? Like I said, an over greasy and like a glossy shine should be all over your face, especially around the T-zone. The area around your nose, on the cheeks, will have like clearly visible and enlarged pores. And your skin like will not show the blood vessels so clearly. But the good news is you generally feel very, very plump on your skin. Like your skin doesn't feel like it's just like dying. And finally, when you pinch your skin, it will actually bounce back really, really fast. Unfortunately, the downside of having an oily skin is that you'll be prone to a lot of breakouts and a lot of whiteheads and a lot of blackheads. But the good news is the skin can change. So from very oily skin, you actually will dry, which is like a double-edged sword. So you're not too sure if it's a good news or a bad news. But that brings me to skin number two, which is dry skin. Now, like I said, skin type is essentially the amount of sebum being produced in your skin. So an underproduction of sebum would mean that you have dry skin. Your skin will feel tight and rough. Even during summers, you will keep feeling like applying moisturizer time and again. Number two, it might be a little flaky and a little scaly, but that depends upon how, what degree of dry skin do you have. Do you have like an averagely dry skin or an extremely dry skin, which are like various conditions. And in that case, you should go see a dermatologist if your like skin is like really falling apart because of the dryness. The fine lines tend to come rather sooner and more visibly. But the good news is there are no visible pores. Like the pores are small. So on your skin, you won't be, unlike oily skin people, you won't be seeing a lot of pores on your skin. So that's good news. And one way to determine it is also, which I will discuss in later detail, if you pinch your skin on your hand or on your face, it will take a while to come back to how it was. So that's a determinant that you have a dry skin. Now, once you know what is oily skin and dry skin, combined skin is pretty much a giveaway. Combined skin is when your T-zone is very oily and your cheeks are essentially dry. So you will notice a lot of greasiness on your T-zone or on your chin. You will also have enlarged pores around your nose in the cheek area, but mostly the outer cheeks will be dry and like really rough and very stretchy. And that's a very easy giveaway that you have combined skin. Now, combined skin is something you may also have through the year. Like when I say the skin changes, it does not mean over the years only. It could also mean that through the seasons. So like in summers, you may have a very, very oily skin, but in winters, you may have a combined skin. So you also need to monitor through the year what your skin type is and also keep changing the products like that. Now, essentially what causes combined skin is that the area around your T-zone and around your nose like overly produces sebum. They're very active pores, and the area around your cheek, they're just like, don't care. They're like, we don't want to produce sebum, so we'll just remain dry. Which takes me to the luckiest skin type, normal skin. Number one, I want all of you to comment if you have normal skin so that I can come and comment and just see how lucky you guys are. Like, you lucky buggers. Who has normal skin? Like, I do not agree with people getting normal skin. It's just not fair. Because you will have no blemishes for the longest time. And if you keep doing your general skincare routine, you have a velvety touch on your skin. You have no enlarged pores. You have no over or underproduction of sebum. It's just so good looking and a normal skin, right? That's why it's called normal. And a very few people in the world will actually have a normal skin. And all you need to do is just, you know, maintain your basic cleanser, toning and moisturizing regime, and you're good to go. Until and unless you, of course, age, and then you need to bring in more like mature age skincare. But till then, you're sorted. So those are the essential four skin types. But having said that, a lot of concerns like sun damage or age and, you know, everything like that may not be addressed in under these four skin types. And that's why we will be doing videos later in the future, where I will discuss how to deal with those. But for now, just know it's good to know the basics so that you can start well. Because there are situations where you may have very oily but a dehydrated skin. Be very sure that a dry skin is not equal to dehydrated skin, which we'll get into later. But just know that these are the basics, but they may not cover the entire spectrum, especially with sensitive skin and mature skin. So sensitive skin is more or less a concern that, you know, skincare products don't suit you, or a slight change in the weather may affect your skin. Right? These are sensitive skin concerns. Also, mature age, essentially when you reach 35 and beyond, you need to bring in some treatments like your serums, your under eye creams. So know your skin type and then see how you need to bring in other treatments and other serums to deal with various concerns. So now that you know the different types of skin, how do you determine them? There are essentially three ways you can determine them, but I suggest you use a combination of at least two of them, if not all three. I believe all three will give you the best result, but at least two of them should be used in combination to give you your skin type. Number one is clean your face and then determine your skin type. Now you can cleanse your face and do not apply any product afterwards and then go to sleep and wake up in the morning with a tissue on your side and dab that tissue on your face and then check it. Other way is that you cleanse your face again in the morning. Do not apply a product for about an hour. No product should be applied for an hour. And then take a tissue and apply it on your face. Now, once you put that tissue on your face, you will know your skin type by seeing the oil patches. Now, if the tissue on your T-zone is oily and your cheeks are also oily, you essentially have an oily skin. This way, the tissue will generally stick to your face and not fall out itself. Number two, if you put the tissue on your face and it just slides down quite quickly and has no visible patches of oiliness, you essentially have a dry skin. Number three, if the T-zone area was oily but the cheek area was dry on the tissue, you have a combined skin. On your tissue, there were only very few patches of oiliness, but very sporadic and spread everywhere and not like around the T-zone and the cheeks, you essentially have a normal skin. Second way is to pinch your skin, which I briefly mentioned in the beginning of the video. You pinch your skin on your face or on your hand and see how quickly it bounces back. If your skin bounces back very quickly to normalcy, you essentially have an oily skin. And if your skin takes a while to go back to normalcy, you have a dry skin. And the third way you can determine is by looking at your pore sizes. Like I mentioned, an oily skin will have enlarged and visibly clear pores around the nose area, and a dry skin will not. So that's why you should use all three of them, or if not all three, at least two of them combined. I suggest you use the dabbing of the tissue method, because that's the most clear giveaway of what kind of skin you have. And once you know that, you'll be able to choose the skincare products which best suit your skin. So guys, those are the different kinds of skin types that exist. I'm pretty sure that will armor you enough to determine your skin type and go buy the skincare products that will be best for your skin. But having said that, my next video on skincare basics will be how to pick and cleanse your face. It is very important to pick the right kind of cleanser based on your skin type and skin concern. There are various kinds of cleansers that exist: gel-based, water-based, oil-based, cream-based, and I will be covering them in detail in my next video in this series. So watch out for that and subscribe to the channel so that you do not miss when I come up with that video and I can give you the best information for your skin and cleansers. And I will take the series further into exfoliation, the importance of sunscreens, and eventually into advanced skincare. So watch out for that. So that's it from me, guys. I hope you liked the video and found it really, really helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Comment below if you have any questions regarding your skin type or any other skin concern questions you may have for me. Or if you found this video helpful, comment that with a thank you too. Check out my last video here, subscribe here, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Bye-bye and stay safe.